Hello and welcome to C++ Weekly. I'm your host, Jason Turner, available for code reviews and on-site training. In this episode, I want to talk about CPM, which I've never used before. And so you're going to watch me on my literal first attempt ever of using this, and we will see if it is in fact as easy to use as it proves to be. Now, CPM is a dependency manager for CMake that is supposed to be trivially easy to use. So let's see how this goes. All right, so it tells us that this is a full complete version of using CPM for dependency management. And it says add package, format lib, and it gives a number and it gives a release. Now, why this one uses a hash and this one uses an at, I am not entirely sure. One of them might refer to a branch, the other one might refer to a tag, or they might mean the exact same thing. But this is clearly a link into GitHub, and it's saying grab this project from GitHub. So the first example has lib format and lomon json and catch two. Now, before I continue, do want to remind you to check out the video description, because a lot of these episode ideas are in fact driven by you. So there is a link to the ability to add your own episode ideas and look and see which episodes are coming up in the future and vote on episodes that you would like to see. I don't strictly follow the order of votes, but I try to prioritize episodes that have the most thumbs up. So be sure to go through and thumbs up the things that you would like to see. Now, I have used CMake enough to know that I need to just go ahead and download the CPM and start from there. So there's the git CPM. This seems to be a tool for automatically downloading CPM into your project. Let's see if there's any docs here on using git CPM and if we want to go that route. Here we go. Simply add the latest release of cpm.cmake or git cpm.cmake to your project's cmake directory. This command will do something. Let's go ahead and execute the command. We're gonna trust them. Okay, I'm in this CPM test folder. Let's see what happens. Yes, let's do that. All right, it did something. And it got cpm.cmake, which interestingly was the git CPM script, not CPM itself. I find that personally fascinating. So let's go ahead and see what happens and if that did what I wanted it to do. Let's go ahead and now copy this full example and see what it does. Okay, now this is expecting a main.cpp to be in this folder. Let's just go ahead and make one. That should fully test if I can use lib format, link to it, and call it. All right. Downloading cpm.cmake, adding package, well, that was pretty quick. Adding package JSON, cmake, build, debug, JSON, subbuild. Okay, so it's getting nlomon JSON, and it's getting format, or has gotten format. Let's see where we are. That is definitely doing something. So it looks like I got all of the configuration stuff for catch and nlomon JSON and CPM and fetch content. Let's see, that's not even with advanced mode on. If I turn on advanced mode, I have many things in here to use local packages. I've always tried to use find package to get dependencies. Okay, so if we turn on use local packages, then it's going to try to use find package to find a system installed version of these things instead of downloading and building its own. So that's an interesting option. I feel like it definitely helps that I am already familiar with CMake to have some idea what I'm looking at here. But let's go ahead and try building this. All right, so it's building catch. Now, this is a version of catch that is actually using C++ files, so it's supposed to be much faster to link against in the long run. It's not the header-only version of catch anymore, I think. Okay, so linking standard library. So it did a static library for catch and for the catch main and linking static library lib format. Okay. So it looks like it chose by default static libs for all these things, and that did in fact print hello world exactly like it was supposed to. Yeah. Okay. That does seem to be nearly as easy as advertised. Although I would be curious about how to get fewer of the configuration options from the dependencies in my CMake script. So we can specify specific configuration versions, options, whether or not we want to download it or configured. I know you can do custom things in here. So that is a git tag or a commit hash versus a published version. And you could do version and tag. I'm slightly confused by that. This is by nature going to be cross-platform and work exactly with all of the tools that you're currently using, your current tool chain, because it's all running from inside CMake. There's no external things to work with. It does work with dependent on having a good CMake list. So not all projects are going to work very well as dependency. It's possible that the sub-projects are going to set policies for you that you don't like. And you can read up more on the documents here. Now, I'm just going to try one quick curiosity. If I type make clean. Okay, so yeah, it does appear to have gone down into catch two and in format and ran clean there as well. Right, so if I'm going to compile again, then I do have to build all of my dependencies again. There might be options to change that behavior. But this is the default here. I suggest that you check this out. There is a comment on my list of episode ideas where someone suggests that they use VC package for all of their main dependencies, and then they use CPM to pick up other smaller dependencies or things that aren't currently in VC package. You might use a similar plan with Conan or whatever package management you choose. And if you go to play with this, I do suggest that you dig down into the examples folder, which I had looked at before I did this episode, just to see. And there are specific options on using CXX opt, doc test, catch 2, range v3, sol 2, of course, speed log, YAML libraries, and then definitely more complicated is if you look at some of the open pull request. That there's some other more complicated examples that haven't been merged in yet, such as this SFML with SDL example. It might inspire you. I don't know why this has not been merged, but something again for you to look at. Well, hopefully this was interesting, maybe taught you about a tool that you didn't already know about. So be sure to check out CPM. Thank you again for watching, and I will see you next week.